Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon you and welcome. Upholding the Fatimiyya's rituals and science is very important, and it is incumbent upon the believer to do so. The believer must get himself ready, and not just spiritually but physically as well. Firstly, spiritually, by infusing oneself with knowledge concerning Lady Fatima, peace be upon her. It is incumbent upon the believer to research, read and listen to the merits of Lady Fatima, peace be upon her, and to propagate her message and to show the world the oppression that she has faced from those who wore the crown of Islam and took the leadership unjustly. These obligations need not a proof, because they are more clear than a shining sun on a hot summer day. But we will provide to you a source. The Holy Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, and his family has said concerning his holy progeny, peace be upon them, I love those who love them, and am at war with those who wage war against them. This narration by the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and his family is a well-known, famous and established report amongst the entire span of sects in Islam. Hence, we can conclude that propagating the message of Lady Fatima, peace be upon her, is an obligation from the contextual stamp of the narration of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and his family. Secondly, the physical preparation falls under our dress code, our manners, morals, and ethics. It spans the entire category of one's appearance inside and out. During the Fatimiyyah days, the believer should wear black attire. The black attire is a sunnah tradition of our prophets and imams, peace be upon them. Wearing the black attire is very important because it materializes the inner feelings and propagates them to the world. When someone sees you wearing black, they will involuntarily ask, what is the reason for this attire? At this point, the ice has been broken and the conversation will flow. You will begin to answer their questions. Hence, the black attire is seen as a prerequisite and icebreaker to the main events. This sunnah is found throughout the books of history, and we learn it from our prophets and imams, peace be upon them. As an example, we will narrate to you a report. It is reported that Imam al-Hasan and al-Husayn, peace be upon them, wore black attire in the city of Kufa after their father's martyrdom. We take our imams, peace be upon them, as an example. And during these days, we wear black attire for their mother's martyrdom. Another crucial point to raise here is that during these days, we must lessen our laughter and useless conversations. If it was our mother's funeral, God forbid, would we do so? I think not, because it would be unethical and immoral to do so. It is important to add as well that our reports have told us that even the general gatherings wherein there is no remembrance of Allah or the Holy Progeny, peace be upon them, is a useless gathering. No matter what angle we analyze, we get to the conclusion that useless conversation and laughter is detested highly in the religion of Islam. Let us pray to Allah that we are able to uphold the Fatimiyyah signs and rituals so that we may be able to propagate her message across the globe. Peace be upon you, my Lady Fatima. Peace be upon your father, husband and progeny. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.